Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today I want to discuss importing video footage and photos into iMovie. Let's do it. Often you have an iPhone, you might have a camera, a video camera, DSLR, whatever device you have, iPad. We're going to walk through the steps of importing your video footage and how to get it from a device into your computer and import it into iMovie so that you can start editing it. And you can take bits and pieces of different video clips, wherever it may be, and create a movie with all of your content. So let's go ahead and get started. We're going to open up iMovie. We're going to head to our media browser. So if it's not already selected, we're going to click on media in the top center. And we're going to look on the left-hand side over here underneath our libraries. Now, when we import content, all of your video footage is imported into an event which actually lives inside a library. Now, over on the left-hand side, I actually have two different libraries. I have an iMovie library and a Vacations iMovie library. You can have as many libraries as you want. By default, you have one that's called iMovie Library. I have another video for that specifically covers the organization of all of your videos and events and libraries and such, but just know that when you're importing video footage, it needs to be within a library and imported into an event. So let's start from scratch. I'm gonna have this iMovie library selected. And honestly, it really doesn't matter what library I have selected, but what we need to do is go to the import window. And there's a couple different ways to do that. We can either use this little import here in the top, and it will give us the option to import the video from a camera or a folder or a memory card. Or we can go up to the file menu and choose import media, and it's going to bring up the same exact window. Now, this is the import window. This is where you have the ability to tell iMovie, where is the video footage coming? And what are you selecting and where are you putting it? So right now I actually have my phone connected physically with a cable to my computer. And there's multiple ways for you to get video and pictures from your phone or iPad or iPod Touch, whatever you have, from your device to your Mac in a couple different ways. You could hardwire it through this. You could use iCloud Photos or you could use AirDrop. And any of those options are available, and some have pros and cons, but this is definitely a surefire free way to do it, and probably the quickest way also. Because when you plug in your phone or any kind of device, it's going to treat it and just copy that information through the cable and go right into your computer. So while this is connected, notice on the left-hand side here, it gives me choices for cameras, and I can choose the FaceTime camera, and I could import directly from here. Hello, there. Or right below there, we have my phone. So on my phone, I have now the ability to see all of the videos that are actually on this device. Notice in the top right, we have a couple choices. I can either choose and tell iMovie to either show me just the videos on my phone or just the photos, or I can say show me all clips, and it's going to show me everything combined. It also gives me the ability to hide things that are already imported. So if last week I connected my phone and I took 5 videos and I already imported those, and now today I took more videos, if by having this checked, it's not going to show me those previous ones that were already imported. And then last we have this little gear which shows us just the clip size of the photographs or videos that are in your browser or down below, and then also the ability to see the waveforms of the audio or the video files. So if I change this back to videos, I can now see all of the videos here. So pretty much you have your choice of where is the videos coming from on the left. You can choose the videos down here by selecting them, and then in the top center is where are you importing these videos to. So notice here, it gives me the choice. When I click on this import to option, it lists the iMovie library, which is one library that I have, and a Vacations iMovie library. And inside of here are different events. So an event is, think of it like a container or a folder. You're putting these video clips into an event to filter and mark your favorites and technically organize them. So I'm gonna create a new event, and I'm gonna put it in the iMovie library. And it's going to say, okay, what do you want to call the event? And I actually just recently got married. Yes. Thank you. It was a blast. Even though during COVID, we still, I mean, seriously, it was awesome. But I digress. So I have some video footage from the phone that I'm going to put into an event. So I'm just going to call wedding day. And we're going to touch, click OK. And so now at the top it says, okay, we're going to import these files into a new event called wedding day inside of the iMovie library. And down here below, I'm only showing the videos. So I want to select all of these videos. And if I click once on each one of them, it always deselects the other. So there's a couple different methods that you can do to choose multiple video clips. I can hold down Command on the keyboard and select multiple videos. So now I'm selecting each and kind of cherry picking the ones that I want. Or if I want to do a selection between two points, I can click on the first one, hold down Shift on the keyboard and click on the last one, and it's going to highlight everything in between. The other option is I do have a choice to import all in the bottom right, but that's going to import all of these other videos and I don't want to do that. Another option, so many options. The other option allows me to click and hold and I can drag this marquee box, kind of the selection, and anything that it touches is going to select it also. So as soon as I let go, all of those clips are selected. Now, a lot of times people want to just select a portion of a clip, and unfortunately I haven't found it possible. So if you know a way, let me know. But if this were a 10-minute clip, I don't have the ability to mark an in or out point and select only 2 minutes of that 10-minute clip. You have to do the entire thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and select all of these, and we are going to choose then import selected in the bottom right. And that's going to create a brand new event over here on the left inside of the iMovie library. And I can see the progress happening of these files being imported and copied from my phone into iMovie. I can also see a progress in the top right. If I click on this little circle, it's just saying, hey, it's importing from my phone 2 of 13 files, and it gives me approximate time, 2 minutes, it'll be done. So now that that is imported, notice I get a little notification in the top right. It says import complete, and then it allows me to eject that camera or the phone. So I'm going to go ahead and click eject here, and then that's going to disconnect that device from the computer. Another option to get videos or photos from your phone or iPad or iPod Touch to your computer is to use AirDrop. AirDrop is a really nice feature. It allows you to wirelessly send files or pictures or contacts from one Apple product to another. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go into Photos, and I'm going to scroll up. We're going to go to Recents, and I'm going to actually just choose some wedding photos so that we can add the pictures, not videos, because we already have the videos. We're going to add some pictures into this event as well. So I'm just going to go through here some of the photos that we took. I'm going to touch select in the top right, and I'm just going to drag my finger here and select all of these pictures. And a few more. Here we go. And so now in the bottom left of the phone, I have the little share button, and I have the ability to do AirDrop. So if I touch AirDrop, it's going to see all of the devices near me. And I'm going to choose Joel, my YouTube laptop. So now on my computer, I get a little notification, and notice in the downloads here in the bottom right and also in the top right, it's saying, hey, I'm AirDropping 87 photos from my phone. And it also shows the little progress on the phone itself with the little blue outline. And everything, when you AirDrop it, it goes into the downloads folder. So then from the downloads folder, we can import that into the event. If I go to the Finder, go to the downloads, I'm going to see all of the pictures here. And once that's done, I will be able to drag them and import them. There we go. It says sent on the phone. So I can touch done in the top right. I can close my phone. And now I'll go back to the computer. Notice in the top right, I can just get rid of this notification. So now I have all of these pictures in the downloads folder. Now, if I select some of these images, if I drag it, I can just drag it over here within this event and I can drag them. So let's actually do that with a handful of them. So if I select these images here, I can either drag in this open window and it's going to import them. If I go back to the Finder here, I'll take another batch of them because I can also drag it to the event name. So I'm going to drag it there. Or I could go up to the import button as well. I can navigate to the downloads folder from here, go to downloads, and it's going to say, hey, it wants access to the downloads folder. That's fine. And then from here, I'm able to, here they are. I can select multiple images just like the video clips, and I can choose from the top menu where these pictures going. They're going in wedding day and from there and import selected. So I'll just go back to the Finder here. We'll select the remaining ones and bring that into this event. So that's option two, to get content from an iPhone or an iPad using the cable hardwired or AirDrop. Now the third option that you have is if you use iCloud Photos, Photos automatically syncs your pictures and videos automatically with your computer without you even doing anything. So what's really nice is in the top left here underneath Photos, if I click or underneath Libraries, I have this Photos option. And Photos ties into Apple Photos, the program, the app. And this gives me the ability to see all of my pictures directly inside of iMovie. So they talk to each other behind the scenes. And notice you can probably hear my computer stressing it out a little bit. So it's taking a little bit longer and it's showing its age for the speed of it. So when I click on Photos, it actually shows me all of the pictures that are in my photo library. Now, if I click on the top left here, I can choose my albums. I can look at the shared albums. I'll be able to see all of that content there. This picture definitely needed a haircut. Yeah, that's back in my high school days with one of my older brothers, and no need to say anymore. So if I look back here, we can go back, choose all of the albums. And again, if you have a ton of photos in Photos, it may take a while to load, but notice I can scroll through here and see all of the organization from my pictures that I have. So if I do all photos, I can then choose, do I want to just show the photos, the videos that I have in there, or favorites? And if I click on videos, it's going to only show me the videos that are in my photos library. And that would, because I use iCloud Photos, that means that I actually wouldn't have to AirDrop any of my pictures or videos to the computer, or I wouldn't have to plug my phone in because everything is already inside of the computer through Photos. So multiple different ways for you to get your content from an iPhone or iPad or iPod Touch to here. So if I go down, notice here's all of those wedding videos that are already on my computer. So I didn't really need to transfer them. That's importing from there. Now let's say that you have a memory card. So you have a memory card, you took it out of your camera, and you want to copy the files now into your computer. The same exact concept applies. I'll take my memory card, I'll plug it in to my computer, and I can either use an adapter, I could plug my camera straight into the computer. And what it does is it automatically opens up the import window, and I can see that the camera is selected, that's the memory card. And the same exact process, I choose at the top center, where do I want to put this video footage? I want to do a new event, because it doesn't make sense that the content that's on this memory card is from Arizona, and I was out shooting a video for this real estate. And it doesn't make sense to put this video inside the wedding day event because it has nothing to do with a wedding. So really, I want to create a brand new event that is maybe labeled Arizona because this is the video footage that makes sense. So I'm going to go to the new event and I want it in the iMovie library. So I'm going to select that and we're just going to call it Arizona. Cottonwood. Click OK. And then I'm going to select some of the clips here. And I don't want all of them because there's a lot of clips on here. So we're just going to do a handful just so that we get the idea. So I'm going to hold down Command on the keyboard and just select some of these clips here. And notice in the top left of them, you can see the duration of them. So this one is 1.9M, standing for minutes, versus 55.1 seconds. So I don't really want really, really long clips because that will take longer. So we're just going to do 18 seconds, 39 seconds, so on and so forth. Okay, so we'll just take these clips here. And again, the same options apply. In the top right, we can filter out, depending on what's on the memory card, either all the clips or videos. We can hide already imported, and then this just gives us the waveforms and the clip size. So now I'm going to do import selected, and notice on the left-hand side, it creates a brand new event inside of the iMovie library, and now those video clips are being copied from that memory card into that event. And then once that's all done, it's going to give me a notification saying, hey, all of your video files are imported. Do you want to eject this memory card? We can do that. We see the little progress in the top right of the screen up here. We can click on this and see the duration of it importing. And these are smaller files, so it doesn't take too long. And now we can eject this memory card. Now, if we don't eject it from here, you can eject it from the Finder. So I can open up the Finder, and over here on the left-hand side, we can click the eject button here, and that will disassociate the memory card from the computer as well. If you just pull the plug on it, there are possibilities where you could corrupt the files on that flash drive or memory card. So always eject it first. Don't just pull the plug on it. But now I can safely remove the memory card, and all of those files are copied into this library. The last option to import videos is to bring it from either a hard drive or maybe they're already on my computer. So notice here on the desktop, if I swipe over, I have these, I have a folder here called swimming pool videos, North Shore videos, and if I double click on one of these, I can see all of the original raw video footage of these clips. I could have gotten it from someone else that gave me a memory card or a flash drive or a hard drive. There's a variety of ways to get these clips to the computer, but this is not importing from a device specifically. It's just the raw files. And so we treat it the same way. If we go back to iMovie here, I can come to the import and do a whole process just like I did before. Go and create a brand new event, select those files from the desktop or an external hard drive, wherever they may live. So I would go to the desktop over here on the left-hand side. Desktop, left-hand side, and here's the North Shore videos. And I can select the clips here, and I could select multiple. And then again, make sure that you're not importing into a different event that you want. And I can create a brand new event here. Let's say I want to create another event and not do it from here. If I select the iMovie library, or the library that I want to import it into, I can go up to File and choose New Event. And this is where it'll allow me to title it here. We'll just call it North Shore. Press return on the keyboard, and now I have an empty event, an empty container, and I can click import media here as well. It brings me to the same exact spot. So I can select two of these clips, choose import selected, and now it's copying them from the desktop into the library. And after that's done, I can actually delete them off the desktop because they're inside of this library. Let's say you accidentally moved them or imported into a different event and you want to move them. Well, you can just drag these clips to a different event. So if I wanted to put that clip into Wedding Day, I just moved it from one event to another. And if I go to Wedding Day, I'll scroll down or up, let's see where it's at. There it is, it's up at the top. So if I went to North Shore again, I selected this clip and I drag it to Wedding Day. I've now just moved that clip from one event to another event. Moved it from one container to another container. That's all I'm doing. And some things to know when you're viewing these events in the clips here, you can go up to the view option and you can sort the events. You can sort the clips by either name, date, or duration, ascending or descending order. So I can do name and it will sort them by name. I can go up to view again, sort clips by duration. So it puts the longest clips at the top versus the shorter clips. I like date, and then I also like to, you can do show separate days and events. That way it's gonna break it down and show you, all right, this was taken April 10th, 2021. And if I scroll down, we should have, yeah, these older video clips from 2018 with North Shore. So that's pretty much importing video content and photographs into these events. Then it's just a matter of organizing them, marking them as favorites, rejecting them, and adding them to a project, and then you're good to go. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something. If you liked this video, click that little like button. If you enjoyed and learned something though, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.